بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في كل وقت وحين. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله ولزوم طاعته، وأحذركم وإياي من مخالفة أمره ونهيه، لقوله عز من قائل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد أيها الأحبة، all praise is due to Allah. We thank Him and we seek His forgiveness. I will send peace and blessings on the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah, and I testify that Muhammad is His final messenger. All who you believe, fear Allah, the fear that He is most deserving of, and do not die unless you are a Muslim or in the state of Islam. My dear brothers and sisters, today we are experiencing challenges, some very challenging times, from media attacks, both local and from outside. We also have ravaging wars that are killing people in numbers. And we also have, on top of this, the usual challenges that we carry and we have and we face from our day-to-day lives. And as we face these ever-changing, constant, dynamic challenges, one seeks to better his character. One should seek to better his personality. And one should seek to make himself stronger so that we are able to pass. Because some of us will pass through these turbulent times and some of us will fail. And when we are talking about strength, my dear brothers, it is not the strength of your body that will get you through. I know we have a gym next door, but it is rather the strength of your heart, the strength of your iman. And we are talking about a strong heart that is pure. That is the sign, and that is the way that you will achieve success. That is the way that you will be able to navigate these challenging times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about this at the beginning of Surah Al-Mu'minun by saying, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. خاشعون, my dear brothers. خاشعون comes from the word خشوع. خشوع, my dear brothers, is when your heart is in complete submission and humility and humiliation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to this in the Quran, according to the Mufassireen, in many senses. When we're saying, what does khushu' mean? Is it fear? Is it humbleness? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, four ayat, that we can extract four different meanings from them. The first one is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَخَشَعَتِ الْأَصْوَاتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ. And from that, we can extract humiliation. وَالَّذِينَهُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Tranquility of the extremities or the body. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Humbleness. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. وكانوا لنا خاشعين. And that is fee from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has many meanings. But how do we connect to that word? The opposite of this is egotism. When people have ego, they have pride, and they have arrogance, and insisting on sins. And on top of all of this, what we probably all go through is ghafla. Inattention. You forget your salah momentarily. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warns us. He warns us about the knowledge of khushu'. He classified this khushu' as a knowledge in itself, in the same manner we classify hadith and seerah as chapters of knowledge. And he says, أول علم يرفع من الأرض الخشوع. The first knowledge that will be removed from the earth as signs of judgment, signs of judgment day, is خشوع. So people will be praying and they're just doing moves. Not having this knowledge leads to corruption of the heart. And you know what happens when the heart lacks khushu'? Reminders that affect it. You can have the best speech, but the heart is not there. The receptor is gone. In fact, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of the words, that affect the heart. It means nothing if you don't have khushu'. And what happens then? Desires usually win. And it forms the direction the person is taking. And this leads to competition in the dunya. Competition for money. Competition for control. Competition for the number of likes on Facebooks and shares. Competition to fulfill a thirsty ego. Competition for fame. How do we expect to succeed if we are lacking this? How do we expect to succeed with sick hearts? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers, gave us a thermometer or a scale to test our state of the heart, or the state of our hearts. And that is the amount of khushu' you have in your salah. It is an indicator of the amount of khushu' in your heart. بقدر ما تخشع في صلاتك فذلك علامة الخشوع في قلبك. انظر إلى نفسك. Look at yourself. How much khushu' do you have in your salah? I doubt that any of us are 100%. But we all try and strive to be 100%. As the Prophet says, my dear brothers, the first thing that the slave will be accounted for on the day of judgment is his salah. If it was accepted, then he will succeed. And if it was not, then he will be a loser on that day. And if there was something missing from his obligatory prayers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then ask, is there anything from his voluntary prayers that we can add to this? My dear brothers, what a scene would it be on that day of judgment when the years that you have lived, you're facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what you have to present to Allah is your good deeds. And at the top of this, Amud al-Din, As-Salah, the pillar of Islam. When Ali ibn Hussein, Ali the son of Hussein, radiallahu anhu, he made wudu. And then his face went yellow. And he was asked, what has become of you, O Ali? He replied, أتدرون بين يدي من أقوم? Do you know between whose hands I'm going to be standing? Do you know who I'm going to face? My dear brothers, just compare for a second the state that we have become in when we're praying and those people. Urwa ibn Zubayr went from Medina to Damascus and he got an infection on his leg. And by the time he got to Damascus and he met the ruler there, it was so badly infected. He got in the doctors and they decided to amputate his leg. So they asked him beforehand, we're going to give you some tranquilizers, sharab, some liquid you can drink so that you can lose your mind, like an anesthetic today. And he told them, if you insist on cutting my leg, do it while I am praying. Because I won't feel the hacking while you are praying. And they did that. They hacked his leg from above the infection in the lively part of the leg. And he did not move in prayer. Such is their belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Complete connection. 100% connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why am I talking about khushu', my dear brothers? We have so many issues to deal with. We can turn this into a political khutbah, and there is a need for this. We can turn this into a local issue. Local issues, there's also a need for this. But of all the issues that are going on, I thought I was going to pick up on this. I will just hone in on this. Because it can be the core of all the problems that we are going through. We are being attacked by media. No matter what we do, we're being attacked. And we have responsibilities towards our brothers and sisters in poorer countries, in war countries. And so we need something to turn to. We need something to re-energize. We need something to re-enlighten our hearts. And that is Salatul Khashi'een. Khushu' of the heart. When we are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start with this. We start with yourselves when you go outside today. Or when you start this prayer, change it. Change your prayer, work on yourself. Before we talk about the politics of Obama and something else. My dear brothers, I want you to think about when your iPhone gets wrecked. You crack your screen. And you take it to the local repairer and he fixes it for you. You buy a $10-$15 cover and you can make it look flashy. But you know what happens when there's a bug in the software? We all know what happens. The local repairer will tell you, send it back to where it came from. Send it back to the source. Send it back to the manufacturer. And you send it there. Because they made it. They put it together. They know it's bugs. They have the solutions for it. And they will send it back to you. And if they can't, they'll give you something else, maybe as compensation. You know, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was troubled, he was facing challenges. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to him. He told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Muhammad, قُمْ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. All the ayat that we read through, connect with your creator. Recharge when you talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talk to Allah in any language. Just talk to him, have a talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have a conversation. And you see the repair going on. Slowly but surely, bit by bit, you will repair your heart. And you will repair all these diseases. We all have diseases. We all have diseases. And you need to repair them and you need to work on this. Nobody else can see your heart except you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A Muslim needs this, my dear brothers. One of the biggest reasons, my dear brothers, for having khushu'. When you're talking about khushu', people associate this with a 5 to 10 minute prayer time. 5 times a day, all up half an hour, 20 minutes of prayer time. But do you think really it's the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. For half an hour you struggle, you make khushu', you're gonna achieve success. One of the biggest reasons for you to achieve khushu' in salah is to have khushu' outside of salah. If you have khushu' outside of salah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pave the way for you to enjoy the 10 minutes or the 5 minutes or the 2 minutes or the 1 minute that you're going to pray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outside of salah, He will test you. It's a hot day outside. We're in our way coming to Salat al-Jum'ah. We're going to get in our cars and leave. It's a very hot day and Allah will test you. He will test your eyes. You want khushu' in Salat al-Asr today? You want khushu' in Salat al-Maghrib today? Your test is outside waiting for you. You can't escape it. If you are steadfast, you will achieve khushu'. In your transactions between people, between institutions, if you fear Allah, Allah will give you khushu' in salah. when you are on the internet, when you are in places or positions when nobody can see you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have khushu', if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the sign is that you will have khushu' in salah. And you know what? It gets better. It is also vice versa. If you have khushu' in salah, it will help you lower your gaze. It will help you fight all your desires. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you if you want. If you want. The choice is up to you. My dear brothers, just remember these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. About a little story. Musa alayhi salam, the story that we know. Musa alayhi salam saw the two ladies standing close to the well. And they weren't going near it because it was crowded. So he asked them a direct question. قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُمَا What is your story? They replied. قَالَتَ لَا نَسْقِي حَتَّى يُصْدِرَ الرِّعَاءِ وَأَبُونَا شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ We won't go to the well and get water from there because it's crowded. And our dad is an old man. Very abbreviated, straight to the point, and no chit-chat. Take yourself in the office today. Put yourself in the shops today. And when a lady comes, you don't control what you speak. You have no boundaries. It's a loose, gray line. You're always in the gray line. Be brief. We do have to mix with other sex. Yes, we do. But be brief. Don't live in that gray line all your life and justify yourself and then ruin it for yourself when you come to pray. You're going to come to pray and you're going to pray. So why ruin it? And just be moving in your prayer. My dear brothers, this leads us to the phenomena. When you are praying behind an imam, when you are praying with ourselves, there are two types of people. The first one, he listens to the words that are being read. Words that talk about Jahannam. And he starts to tremble. He starts to have some fear. His body goes hot and cold. He may cry. And when the ayat are talking about Jannah, he's filled with inspiration. He was longing to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the state of the person that gets affected by the Qur'an. He has khushu'. And on the other hand, the person is looking at the carpet and saying, why did they miss that stitch there? Why is the line too big? Why is his socks yellow? He's disturbed. There's no khushu' in his salah. He has no connection with what is being read. His heart is somewhere else. And the Imam is another planet. My dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes those people in the Quran. And he says about them that their skins will soften to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he also talks about the other people. فَوَيْلُ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ The hearts are very hard. They've been hardened. When they listen to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where do you see yourself right now? Or where do you want to be? When you come to the mosque, or when you make a prayer wherever you are, and you have in your heart a single bit of kibar, arrogance, pride, you're better than the other person. I'm praying 5 times a day, look at this guy, he's barely praying. So deep inside you feel better than this guy. I have a bid, I have a dishdashi. And therefore I'm better than him, I'm more religious. If you have that dot in your heart, how is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to give you khushu'? It's a blessing, it's a ni'mah. You got to work on yourself. Work very hard and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَيَفَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونصلي ونسلم على الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those people that have success in this dunya and to bless us with khushu. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us near the 100% at least when it comes to khushu. But my brothers, when you are talking about khushu, let's have a one-on-one talk. Have a one-on-one talk between yourself. How much of your salah do you have khushu? If you get to 80%, then you're doing very well. Even when it comes to pray now, Ali radiallahu anhu was challenged by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He told him, I will give you my hat if you achieve khushu' in your salah. And he prayed, and he thought, is he going to give me the old hat or the new hat? This is something normal, my dear brothers. Don't tie yourself thinking that I have to be 100%. We are humans at the end of the day. وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. We are weak. But it is like sport. Like when you go to the gym next door. Or like when you're doing a marathon. No man can do a 10-kilometer race if he hasn't run for years. Unless he's super. You're working it day by day. You want to do a 100-meter, 100-kilometer cycle race. You start bit by bit. You work your way through. You want to swim for 1 kilometer. You start with 50 meters, 100 meters, and so on. You build your fitness. If you want to lift 100 Ks, 100 kilograms, you do it bit by bit, and likewise with khushu. You work on it, and you work on it. And love that process. If you push yourself to love that process, Allah will make it easy for you. And you will achieve. And you will find, fa'lan, you will find your salah is really your spiritual break, not your physical break. You know, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Bilal, radiallahu anhu, أَرِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَالِ. Give us some comfort with it. This is the view that they wanted to have. This is the view that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم wanted us to have. And today it's like, oh, I've got to pray. I've got to tick the box. We need to move from that attitude, my dear brothers. Inshallah, I will go through with a summary of what some of the ulama have said. And I'll give you 5 points that relate to the internals. To the internals of the heart, and inshallah, if we change this, we can achieve khushu. Or we can achieve at least part of it. Number one, your heart has to be there in salah. And this means emptying your heart from anything else that the heart loves. And why do we say this? Because the heart has to be attached to something. The heart is either with the dunya or with the akhirah. It's not in between. So if you feel that your heart is attached to dunya, then belittle this dunya. Haqqir dunya. Belittle this dunya all the time. And know that this dunya is really a tool to the akhirah. It is not a destination. If you can understand this and really conquer that heart in your heart, then you achieve this. Number two, think about the words and try and understand them. Try and understand what is being said. You know, we can just, when the imam is praying, we can just switch off for a second. And sometimes we switch off willingly. I don't want to understand. I can't be bothered. I'm tired. Push yourself to understand. If you can't understand the words of the Quran, then you have a task ahead of you. Read. There's plenty of places to read. Plenty of mashayikh, plenty of courses. If that combines, if your understanding combines with your heart being present, then you're going to achieve something you have not achieved. Your heart and your understanding. When the Imam reads ayat, you probably read before. وَيَوْمَ إِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ. Wallahi, new meanings will come to you. Every day we read ayats like this that talk about the Nar, talk about Jahannam. But you read it, a new meaning comes. It's a thought process. You start to think about it, you tremble. Number three, عَظِّمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Expand on the greatness of the ayat that you are hearing. And you can be listening to your boss at work. You can give him your heart. And you can give him your mind. But you won't give عَظَمَةَ to his words. He's just talking. I'm there, my heart and my mind's with him. But there's no azama in his words. But the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have azama. Because no matter how much you search, you will always find new meanings. Try and understand the tafsir. Read the tafsir of Surah Al-Fatiha. Volumes. Shay'un azim. Kalimat azima. On top of this, number four, feel the haybah of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The status. Have some fee, elegance, prestige for the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is born out of ta'zim. This is born out of ta'zim of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Haybah is being scared from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you know what? We get scared from the scorpion when we're in the same room. We get scared from the snake too. But we don't have haybah for it. So we have haybah for somebody in charge. The king is coming. You have haybah for him. And so you must have haybah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lastly, my dear brothers, beg. Be a beggar in your salah. Beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cry. He is the only one that you will enjoy begging for. You will cry and cry and you will enjoy begging for him. Unlike that king that had the haybah. You're standing in front of the king. If you're going to beg, you're not going to enjoy that. But you can beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have this raja'. You're facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Feel your weakness. Feel the fact that you will say, oh Allah, I repent to this sin that I'm going to do. I repent to this sin that I'm doing. I've been doing it, Allah, I will repent. And you go inside and you'll commit it. And you know that. You know that you are weak. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that you are weak. And therefore you're asking for his, you're begging, oh Allah, please forgive me. Forgive my weakness. Such is the beauty of talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your salah. You know this ibadah called munajah? When you're chatting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't deprive yourself of this. Finally, my dear brothers, it goes without saying, when you're going to pray, you must choose the appropriate place. Choose the appropriate place to pray. Don't pray in the corridors, or in busy places, in the middle of Darling Harbour, on the beach, and expect to get khushu'. At the same time, when you come to pray, in a busy day, you all have busy days, try and unload your mind. Your mind is going at 1,000 miles an hour. We process 6 gigabytes of information per second. Unload that mind. If you have things to do, write it down on a piece of paper. Write it down on your mobile, then go into your salah. You've offloaded something. Again, when you're going to pray, pray slowly. Take it easy. And don't choose long ayat. Don't choose long surah. Don't pray for long. It's better to pray short and have a salah full of concentration than to have a long, long ayat, long surah, and you lose the concentration, especially when you're with others. Be considerate. You can pray long when you're by yourself. It's very enjoyable. It is very nice. But do it by yourself. You will feel the difference. My dear brothers, if you have khushu', and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us khushu', you will drive away the shaitan. Khushu' will help you lower your gaze. Khushu' will soften your heart. You will be receptive to reminders. It will elevate your status on the day of judgment. And it will give you success. And khushu' will solve many of the individual issues that we have. And therefore, will help the ummah. We'll begin fixing the ummah from the bottom. Begin fixing yourselves. And wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pave the way. تقدم